This is the process shot. I'm Michael, I'm here on my own, and I've seen The Nannies, a short Danish film from Signe Barvild Stare, released last year. It's an autobiographical documentary that looks at Stare's childhood, and more specifically, a period of her life after the death of her mother, wherein she was raised by a succession of young visiting nannies. Having no strong recollection of this time herself, she interviews her father and some of those nannies to try and understand what that time must have been like, using the film and various actresses to recreate some of those days, even if the end result is clear artifice. One of the more outstanding elements of the film is its cinematography and pacing, which adopts a slow, almost static approach to its visuals. Save for some home movie footage, the camera itself never moves, keeping things focused on what's ahead of it, while those within the frame also stay still or move slowly or methodically, often looking directly into the camera, and creating a sort of living painting of these relatively mundane scenes from the director's childhood. It's an interesting and expressionistic choice for sure, almost crossing the relatively boring and slightly ambiguous elements of one's childhood with the discomfort of trying to access long-forgotten memories. The film eventually takes advantage of this approach by staging the nannies in unusual poses or situations, such as sitting on a wall in a group or lining up to enter the home all at once. However, the slowness of the film definitely works against it. It's an appropriate pacing, sure, but it ends up creating a sort of sleepiness that might cause the viewer to lose attention to the film. This is accentuated a bit by the film's soundtrack, or lack thereof. The music that is used in The Nannies is minimalistic and quiet, almost like a lullaby. And it continues to build up the tone of the film, but again adds to the film's overall sleepy and dreamlike ambience. Otherwise, the film's interviews are generally punctuated by silences between bits of dialogue. Overall, the film has a very somber tone, which is a given considering its subject matter, and while it works for the film's story, it's not exactly something that works in its overall favor. The movie actually does pick up a bit nearer the end, as the director comes to learn more about the circumstances of her mother's death, but by that point, you end up wishing the whole film had this pacing. The Nannies. Signe Barvild Stare? 2020. 2.5 stars. I don't think I'd recommend it myself, but you might get more mileage out of it. Anyways, that's it for me. You know how it goes. Leave a like, leave a comment, and subscribe for more reviews. And again, you might get more from this movie than I did. It's just not my bag. Maybe I should add something like that for my recommendations.